50 years ago tonight, Chicago was in the middle of its biggest snowstorm ever. Over 29 straight hours, a record 23 inches of snow fell, whipped up by 50-mile-an-hour winds. It paralyzed the city for days. CBS 2's Jim Williams lived through it and in this original report explains what Chicago does now to prepare for a blizzard that it couldn't do on January 26th and 27th, 1967.
That's how young we were. Look at that.
These home movies capture a family's joy and a 50-year-old chapter of Chicago history that stands alone.
Oh, Sue's throwing the kids. Yeah.
Bob and Sue's Erkland reflect what so many felt during the blizzard of 1967.
First thing that comes to your mind when you think about the great snow of 67?
It was scary.
Fun.
Fun for Bob and Sue's and their children.
He built a big snow tunnel for us to crawl through. Or walk through. He said they can walk through it. It's that high.
Danger for other Chicagoans.
All roads are blocked in the area.
WCGO Radio described the peril in the south suburbs.
Fire trucks at the fire station 3 are just completely snowed in.
Just after a record high 65 degree day, the blizzard caught Chicagoans off guard. Crooked lines of cars and buses were trapped in snow, and police had to rescue drivers who ran out of gas. Snow removal crews were simply overwhelmed.
And even with the equipment that they had, they really couldn't keep up with it.
Wind gusts over 50 miles per hour, snow drifts of 4 to 6 feet, basically paralyzed Chicago for over 2 days.
It remained Chicago's biggest winter storm.
My father was a Chicago police officer, and there was no staying home for him. He walked to work down the middle of this busy street for miles without a moving car in sight.
If we had a similar snowstorm today, would we be better prepared for it?
Much better.
Forecasts today are far more sophisticated thanks to satellites and supercomputers.
We usually know how much is coming, and it gives us an opportunity to prepare much better.
Streets and sand drivers have cell phones, their trucks have GPS, and cameras and road sensors are scattered throughout the city.
It'll tell us if that road is wet, if it's ice.
Back in 1967, no one knew beet juice could fight snow. John Stanikinos drops it now.
So as the snow falls onto it, it can't bond onto the pavement.
But as Bob and Sue's Erkland recall, a half century ago, they had something timeless.
I think what an amazing time it was because everybody came together.
For young people, descriptions of the great snow of 1967 might sound like an exaggeration, a tall tale that's grown over time, but it really was that big and that dangerous. 26 people died. Rob and Erica, the blizzard was a turning point in snow removal in Chicago. The next year, the city went out and bought a whole lot of new equipment.
So 50 years ago tonight, do you remember exactly what you were doing as the snow was falling in record numbers?
I just remember thinking I won't have school tomorrow.
Very simple.
Or the next day.
A lot of them were thinking that.
Yeah.
Also, we showed the 23 inches, but in some places, due to the snow drifts, it was actually a lot higher.
It was so high that in my neighborhood on the south side, West Chatham, kids were jumping off of roofs into the snow.
Wow. And nobody getting hurt.
And nobody getting hurt.
So much.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jeff.